I'm Marcus. Welcome to middle school. I'd like to talk to you about moving up from elementary school to middle school. I know you must have a ton of questions about stepping up to a bigger school with more responsibilities, but I want you to know, I'm here to help. Come on. I remember when I was getting ready to start middle school, I was so worried. All I could think about was, will there be more homework and will it be harder? What if I can't find my classes in that big school? Do the big kids beat you up? That's all I could think about. And as it got closer to the start of the school year, I found myself wondering if I even wanted school to begin. I guess most elementary students form most of their opinions about middle school from what their teachers, older brothers and sisters, and friends say. Your teachers might have told you things like, you need to learn this now because next year your middle school teachers will expect you to know it, or you better do your homework this year because next year your work will be harder. Even if you don't take it seriously now, you'll only be hurting yourself. Older friends, brothers and sisters will sometimes try to scare you by messing with you, saying things like, next year when you're a little sixth grader walking down those crowded halls, the eighth graders will just push you out of the way. To tell you the truth, most of that's just hogwash. First off, you'll need to be more mature when dealing with your teachers, but that's nothing you can't handle. Remember when you were in third grade and you worried about going into the fourth grade? That all worked out, right? You learn as you grow. Sure, things will change, but just remember, all the sixth graders will be going through the same thing as you. And the seventh graders and the eighth graders have been through it before. You're not alone. There's always someone to talk to. So let's get started. First, let's start with learning expectations. What is expected of you?
I think the expectations of coming to middle school are going to be very similar to what they are at the elementary school and what they are at the high school. Middle school is no different. Teachers are going to expect kids to do their best. That's all we ever ask, is for students to really try and put forth their best effort when doing assignments. I think a lot of students get nervous coming to middle school from fifth grade because it's such a bigger school, and they're going from maybe having one or two classes a day to having six or seven classes. And so one of the biggest struggles we see with sixth graders is just a matter of keeping themselves organized.
So you're going to have to learn to be organized, making sure that you take your planner. We have a little planner. Where did I put it? Right here. You will have a planner that you will be able to work and put all your daily activities in there, your homework assignments that are due when they're due. We also have a thing called Teacher Ease that your parents will be able to access and will be able to get on there and check your grades. So those are the things that you're going to be responsible for. Those are the responsibilities that you have as you come to middle school.
So what we suggest to students is that they set aside a little bit of time each night, maybe 30 to 45 minutes, where they sit down every night and go through their backpack, get it organized, do whatever homework needs to be done, and if nothing else, read a book, do some journal writing, that sort of thing, to kind of keep up with all of their different classes.
Then there are academic expectations.
In middle school, we really expect students to know the basic facts. We know that we expect them to be able to read at grade level. We expect them to have some basic computational skills in math, know how to add, subtract, multiply, and divide, work with fractions, that sort of thing. And the reason that we want our students to come with that knowledge is so that we can go to middle school level mathematics, reading, social studies, and science.
So what's going to happen is you're going to have to make sure that you pay attention to what's due in which class, because you're going to be the person who knows what's due in each class. Your teachers, why they talk to each other, they each are trying to teach you a different content area. So what you want to do is you want to make sure that you know what's due in language arts, what's due in math, what's due in science, what's due in social studies.
You're going to find if you can be successful as a fifth grade student, you can be successful as a sixth grade student. The work isn't that much more difficult. It's not like all of a sudden you're in sixth grade and the work is 20 times harder.
And of course, behavioral expectations.
Also, when you come to middle school, what happens is you go from a smaller school to a larger school. And anytime you go to a larger school, your expectations and your responsibility on the individual become a little bit greater. So what we have is we have general rules that everyone needs to comply with. And the expectation is we think you're old enough and we think you're mature enough that you're going to be able to handle it.
One of the things that we do expect of students is that they respect each other and respect themselves and respect their teachers and any other adult in the building. One of the problems that we have with sixth graders is sometimes they're not used to the amount of freedom that they have in the school building. For instance, in elementary, you're still walked in a line from one place to the next, and in middle school, there's a little bit less of that. And so one of the problems we might have is, for instance, kids running to get to the lunch line, and really there's just no need for it.
What I like to let sixth graders know is that if you are where you're supposed to be doing what you're supposed to be doing, you're not going to have any problems in middle school. You know, just the expectation of the character counts that you've been exposed to at the elementary, that carries on to middle school. The responsibility, the caring, you know, that type of behavior here at the middle school, that doesn't change. We expect you to behave yourselves.
We want students in class seated and ready to go when that bell rings. It's not like jumping in the door and just getting here on time. We like students to get to school and have a few minutes to kind of unwind and say their hellos and talk to their friends, and then when the school day begins at 8:35, it's time to learn.
So when we all come together, we expect everybody to be respectful, everybody to honor each other, and we also really want to make sure nobody's bullying. And there's a difference between bullying and being unkind. We don't want any unkindness either. But if you bully, we do work very hard to make sure that you understand that you're not going to be allowed to bully. If you've got a group of people that kind of follow you, and then you use that to be unkind to somebody, or you make somebody's life miserable, that won't be tolerated at any middle school. So every middle school will address that and will say you're acting like a bully and we cannot have it, and then the consequences will be applied appropriately. Everybody has a right to go to school, have a good time, feel welcomed, and nobody has a right to take that away from anybody. And that's something that all middle schools really strongly focus on.
Now most of that is a no-brainer, and us middle schoolers pretty much understand what's expected of us. It's all about doing your best and showing respect. Let's talk about questions some of you may have concerning what I call other stuff.
What different things are there to do in middle school?
There are so many different things to do. You'll definitely find something that's fun where you'll meet new friends. From sports, band,
or choir.
How do you switch between classes?
Simple. Bell rings, you grab your stuff, and you head to your next class. It might seem kind of crazy the first couple of days, but you'll get used to it in no time.
Marcus!
Yeah.
What if you have homework in a lot of your classes on the same night?
If that happens, you need to talk to your parents or an older brother or sister to ask for their help to organize your homework. One important thing to remember is you don't want to put off your homework. It can pile up quickly. You don't want to spend your whole weekend doing homework if you fall behind, or worse, you don't want your grades to fall.
What is lunch like?
Lunch is where you get to eat and hang out with your friends. The cool thing is you don't have to sit in a certain spot, like in elementary school. You get to sit with your friends wherever you like.
What do you do if you need help? Like if you're lost or sick or being bullied.
If you need help for any reason, you could ask any adult who works at the school for help. Of course, if you are sick, you should ask to see the nurse. If another student is bullying you, or you see another student being bullied, you should tell a teacher, a counselor, or a principal. Remember, if you have any questions, there's always someone there to help you. You are never alone.
Hey, Marcus.
Hey.
What's going on?
So until then, enjoy your last days as an elementary student. Stop me in the hall and say hi if you see me when you get to middle school. See you next year. Get used to it in no time.
Middle school starts at 8:35, and sorry about that, at 8:35.
Which is what the question is. So, you guys, I can't do that. I gotta start again. That was okay.
Kyle Sloan.
Lunch is... I remember when a Cheeto.
Sunshine!
Ha 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 ha, stay and laugh, stay and laugh. Ha 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 ha, stay and laugh.